representatives from the Hall of Fame are here tonight, awaiting the jersey and the football. But still work to be done. In a critical game in the NFC right now, if you consider the way things are shaking out, especially considering the NFC East for the Skins. Ball is down, and Ingram quick to recover on it. That was Deron Payne at 319 pounds, who was crashing home on the fellow Alabama alum.
Just a dancing bear, man. The guy making moves, coming from the inside out, feeling the screen. Not just being a blind dog in a meat house and running everywhere. He feels the offensive lineman, goes to the screen, and makes a play, an athletic play. Nice job there by Payne.
Great awareness by the big guy, though.
Yeah,
he's really coming into his own. You know how big physical he is inside? But seeing him play that way on screen plays, that's rare.
Second and 18.
Brees with plenty of time, comes to the near side to Carr, and Carr makes his way to the 49.
You know, they drafted Deron Payne this year, and they teamed him up with Jonathan Allen, who they drafted last year. He missed 11 games, so it simply set up two number one picks, the Bama boys inside, and they're making a difference, not only with their physicality in the run game, but they're athletes. They can chase, just as Deron Payne did on the screen play.
But they've got to find a way to bring some pressure. Drew Brees, for that type of time, you
know, 91, a big guy.
He cannot expect this.
Said 91, a big guy. Yeah.
Typically you get that from Ryan Kerrigan when it comes to the quarterback pressure. They do bring it, catch it from man, and they get to him. And guess who it is? Ryan Kerrigan with his first sack as a flag comes in late. Guy who's had 47 sacks since 2014. His first of this year.
After the play was over, unnecessary roughness, number 35, defense. 15 yards will be added to the end of the play. Automatic. First down.
That was the safety, Monte Nicholson, who was coming in on the blitz. Yeah, they decided to bring some pressure. Mark Eaton was late getting there on the play. You can see him, though, when he pushes Mark Ingram off that, he can't do that. Play's over, he's down. See him? They're going to call it every time. He went right over the top of Kerrigan. Just such a silly, silly penalty to get after Kerrigan comes up so big for Jay Rudenstein.
Well, that's just something you can't do. This is the second drive that the Redskins have committed a penalty that allowed the Saints to keep going on their drive. Remember the Josh Norman penalty? He was holding earlier. Now you get the personal foul. The Redskins are hurting themselves, guys.
Timeout taken by the Saints.